subs, today's video is going to be a DIY how to make a ham ranch pasta salad with cheddar cheese in it. I thought I'd show you how to do this. This is originally a bacon cheddar ranch pasta salad, but I don't like bacon, so I use ham instead. So I'm going to show you how we make a ham cheddar ranch pasta salad. So let's get started.
What you'll need is, here's the recipe if you can screenshot it. I sped it up because my video got too long. So you need a mixing bowl. It's about a 4.5 quarts. You need some macaroni, elbow macaroni. You'll need some cube ham, it's about 4 ounces, I think. You need a whole red onion. You'll need a half a cup. Can I go find my 1 cup measurer? You'll need mayonnaise and Miracle Whip. You'll need a saucepan. You'll need a strainer for your noodles. You'll need a ranch. I think it's like an 8 ounce ranch, or makes 2 cups. You'll also need some cheddar cheese. I started eating it because I was hungry. You also need some wrinkled cut carrots, or just carrots you cut. You also need some peas. I'm using Costco organic peas. You also need a cutting board, a knife, and a spatula and a spoon. First thing you want is to get a pot of water going. I filled it halfway full. Then you want to put it on your stove for on high, and mine's electric, so I can have all this stuff sitting over there without it getting burnt. First thing you want to do is take your 2 cups of ranch dressing, pour it into your big bowl. Now, you don't follow the recipe on the back because that's not what you're going to do. You want to take a cup of each mayonnaise and Miracle Whip, and yes, I did end up having to open mine with my, I use my teeth, and that's okay if you use your teeth to open things. So that's what I did right there. I just opened it, and yeah. Alright guys, so I'm opening my Miracle Whip and mayonnaise with my teeth, but because I can't get them open with my fingers, I don't have long enough fingernails. So what you guys are going to want to do after that is put a cup of mayonnaise and Maricopa in there. I don't actually measure mine very well. I have a half cup measurer, which I couldn't find my cup measurer. I got 2 spoons, which I forgot to mention earlier. But I don't, like I said, I don't measure. It doesn't have to be equal. It says third, fourth cup to 1 cup, which I always do one cup of each. Right now I'm doing 2 half cups to make a cup, so I'm not really measuring. As you see there, you can't really see what I'm doing because I keep blocking it with my, yeah, so I just did that. I licked the spoon, and I'm not using them for the mayonnaise, guys, don't worry. So I'm going to put, just finish that up. I'm going to put about the same amount of Miracle Whip mayonnaise in there. And then that's what we're basically doing. I just finished that, and now I'm going to start mix it up. I'm putting the covers back on my Miracle Whip mayonnaise, and then I'm going to take my spatula and stir it up. It should look something like this when you're done, and then it should look like a ranch stuff that you mix up. And I'm mixing it up. It should look really nice. It should actually kind of look like frosting, I guess, when you mix it totally up. That's what it looks like. And now you're going to want to cut up your cheese and onions and your ham. That's what I'm doing right now. I'm reading the recipe. So you need about 4 to 6 pieces of bacon. Going to use, here's the ham that I'm using. Or you need 6 to 8 pieces of bacon that are cooked. Now I'm going to start cutting my onions, cheese, and my ham. So you're just going to take your knife and your knife and just cut onions up. This is where I sped it up, guys, because I really don't think you need to see how I cut onions, because cutting onions is pretty easy. And you can see I moved the camera a little bit so you guys could see what I was doing. But you just cut the onions into little bits And if you have anybody that doesn't like onions, you can just cut them up small. So now I'm just cutting onions right now. I know this is a weird thing to record, but I thought you guys would want to see me cutting onions. That's why I sped this part up, because this is a part that took a little longer to cut onions, and it is just very nice. It is just to cut your onions into the desired. It says to cut a full onion, but you do not have to cut a full onion. If you don't want to, you can do whatever you want. So I'm going to cut my onions, and I will be back in the next clip. Guys, now I just finished cutting my onions. Now I'm going to put them in a bowl. Now, I showed it the clip last one, but you just cut them in two, like, different sizes. They're small enough sizes that you don't choke on them. But yeah, so that's what I do. I'm putting them in a bowl to set aside for a little bit. The next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to be putting the cheese and cut the cheese and ham on that. Same thing. Yeah. So I'm just going to cut them up, and then you guys will see that. And I'm showing you how much onions that makes. It's a lot of onions, but if you like onion, that's good. I'm now going to start cutting the sharp cheddar that I like to use. Now, make sure you like the brand you're buying. I bought a brand, I don't remember what, I think it was Food Club or something. I didn't like that cheese very much. So, it's a whole thing of cheddar cheese, and I am just going to cut it into cubes. And then I am going to finish that. And then that's basically what this clip is going to show you, how to cut cheese. But it's nice. And then after I finish cutting the cheese, I start cutting the ham. But I don't cut the ham that much because of it is a bigger chunks. And I like the ham bigger chunks, but I like to cut it a little bit so it's not too big of chunks. And then now what I'm doing now is I'm taking my Food Club macaroni, elbow macaroni, and I am just putting about, it's supposed to be 3 cups, but I just measure. Now I am putting in for 9 minutes. And then I am starting to finish cutting the cheese, and then we're going to cut the ham. But I do not, when you cut the ham, I'm not cutting the ham too much. I'm just cutting the ham a little bit. And yes, I was feeding my dog cheese while I cut. I pretend to drop it for him. That's what I do. Now I'm almost finished with the cheese. Now I'm stirring the noodles, and now I'm taking my ham, and I am cutting it open with a knife because I don't feel like trying to get it in with, get it open, so I'm just dumping it on my cutting board, taking it a little bit, and like, slicing it up a little bit, but not too much, because you don't want to overslice it, because then it's going to get really hard. Now I'm going to start taking get my peas and my carrots all in there. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to dump in the onions and the cheese and the ham. That's what it looks like. So I'm stirring up the ham, cheese, and onions in the ranch mixture. Now I'm just doing a little bit of cleanup right now, and I'm stirring my macaroni and cheese right now, or the noodles, the elbow noodles. I'm just cleaning up my mess that I made, and I don't know why I kept you recording, but that's basically what I'm doing right now, is just cutting the cleaning my kitchen a little bit. I just realized that I hurt myself. I did not burn myself. I'm dumping in a little bit of corn, not peas and carrots in there. And I'm letting them sit for 4 minutes. And I'm letting them do it. I accidentally got like a piece of my Miracle cover in there, which is kind of gross. But now I'm doing it for, it's gonna cook for about 5 minutes. The noodles, peas, and carrots. And then I guess I'm just mixing up the mixture. And now I'm just gonna clean my kitchen up quick. Now it is getting closer to being done. It's very hard to test noodles, but I test the noodles. I actually turned it off, but now I'm gonna test the noodles really quick.
And then after you drain them, you're going to wanna
and I'm seeing if they're done. And what I'm basically going to do is I am going to taste it. And I'm going to taste my noodles and see if they're done. And sometimes they're done before 9 minutes. And I'm cleaning my mess now. Sorry about the noise in the background if you can hear my train going by my house. But yeah, now I'm just cleaning it up, my house up, and it is just, I'm cleaning it up. I don't know why I'm recording this, but I guess I'm showing you how this works. I'm just throwing away everything. One thing I do have to mention, if you are a person that makes a sandwich, you could save the, or soups, you can save the ends of the onions, but I have no need for them. In a little bit, I will be testing the noodles to see if they're done. Now, I'm almost done. Now it's starting to, the noodles, peas, and carrots are starting to boil nice and hard. And it is good. And it's got about like 1 minute and some seconds left. And I'm just going to move you and you're going to see. So now I'm gonna taste the noodles to see if they're done. They do not have to exactly go for 9 minutes, 10 minutes, whatever. Whatever they're done, but now it's really hard to test a noodle. Why did I do that? Guys, I'm laughing at my own self because I tried to touch the spoon. The spoon is warm. Now I am tasting it. The one dropped on the floor for my dog. And now I thought I cleared my timer and a little bit it went off. But you guys did not hear that because I voiced over it. Now you're at my kitchen. Yes, there's a house right next door to me. That's why it looks like I have a curtain on my one door. Now I'm just going to dump in my noodles, peas, and carrots and put warm water, cold water on them so they cool off. You can see the steam going off of them. When you get most of the steam off, then you're going to want to dump them into your blue bowl, which I'll show you in the next clip. Then you're going to want to take your bowl with all your other ingredients in and dump the bowl in. I find this pasta salad really delicious, really good, and it is really good, guys. They recommend putting it in the freezer for the first first time, and you're going to have it look like this. So now I'll see you guys in my next clip.
Video, comment down below what you want to see next, and if you try to recreate your my pasta salad, make hashtag cool75 DIY pasta salad. So I'll see you guys in my next video, but please follow me on my social media at cool75 or crazy crafts or more on Instagram, or on my Facebook at crazy crafts or more, Twitter at crazy crafts or more, or cool75. And a question of the day is, do you like making pasta salads? I love making pasta salads. The only thing I don't like to do is clean up. So see you guys in my next video. Bye.